On today's episode, we're going to check out the new Creality Silent Board. It's a version 4.2.7, 32-bit processor with silent TMC drivers. And we'll install it on this guy, the Ender 3 Max, right here on Film of Friday. Film of Friday is brought to you every week by the generous donations of these Patreon supporters. This video is also brought to you by PCBWay.com, a great place to get low-cost circuit boards and also low-cost assembly services, all from one place, PCBWay.com. Creality has made things very confusing. They switched Ender 3 and Ender 3 Pro to 32-bit boards, but non-silent drivers. All the older machines were 8-bit boards with non-silent drivers. These I've all updated to silent drivers in one way or another. So if you want to do that to a newer machine and still maintain 32-bit, they released the version 4.2.7, which is 32-bit with silent drivers. Now you can install this 4.2.7 on any Ender 3 and bring it up to 32-bit and get silent drivers, so it's not a bad deal. But I wanted to try it on an Ender 3 that had the 32-bit board but non-silent drivers and see if it makes those steppers quieter. And the only machine that I have like that was the Ender 3 Max. But the Ender 3 Max, the base of it, is essentially an Ender 3 Pro. It's no different from the electronics point of view. So I'm going to show you how to install this 4.2.7 on basically an Ender 3 Pro, and we'll see if it makes it quieter. And I'm also curious if it'll get rid of some of that ringing that I saw on the X and Y axis in my review. For safety, shut off power or just unplug it. And the first screw you want to take off is on the top. It's under the bed. Then there's three on the bottom, one at the back, two at the front. And then that cover should come off. And look at this, I got a connector for the fan. I showed this in a previous video. They copied this idea, I love it. And then you have to get all the glue off the connectors. I just grab them on the needle nose pliers and pry them out. And then one by one, I take the connectors and put them in the same spot. This way I don't mess anything up. I just go one by one until I get all the connectors in place. Once I get the last of the white connectors, then I gotta go to the screw terminal ones. So I want to take these stepper motor wires out of the way. They're all labeled so I don't have to go one-to-one with those, and push those out of the way so I can get to the screws a lot easier. But then I go back to one by one. I'll take the wire out and put it in the same spot on the new board. This way I keep everything in the proper order. And then once these are all in place, the last two are the power and ground. Now these two I tend to do together because they stay together, and that way I make sure I got them right. And pull out the LCD cable, which is this ribbon cable, and then there's four screws to remove that hold the board to the base. Once you get those four screws, this board comes right out. Put the new board in place, line up the holes, and then put the screws in. I like going with the center one first, and then I work my way around. And then finally get the fourth screw in. Now I can put the steppers back in, and they're all labeled. This one's X, and then there's a Y label, that one's Z. And then E is the last one, the extruder. Put the ribbon cable back in, and now I can put this cover back on. So I put the upper corner on, make sure all wires are inside the box, and then the last two screws. And then there's one screw on top, and this thing's assembled. I didn't do it before for before and after, but let's see how quiet this is. This is definitely quieter than it was before. All I'm hearing is the fans. So I'm going to print a temp cube and see how the ringing looks on this thing. And when it was done, no better. This is terrible. So I got to work on this. This 4.2.7 silent board definitely made the Ender 3 Max more silent, but didn't fix the ringing problem. That's something else. And speaking of circuit boards, if you're into electronics and you want to design your own circuit boards and also get them soldered together with components and everything, check out PCBWay. Not only do they offer low-cost circuit boards, but you can get them to assemble it through hole parts, surface mount parts, so you can give them the whole design. They'll build it up and ship it back to you. Gerber files, bill of materials, give it to them. They'll build it, ship it back to you at very affordable prices. So check out PCBWay if you want to build your own circuit boards. PCBWay.com. That's it for this week. If you like what I'm doing here, maybe check out some of the videos popping up. And if nothing else, click on that CHEP logo and subscribe. I'll see you next time right here at Film of Friday.